There are a lot of members of Congress, Republicans particularly, who are making moves early and are certainly eyeing a run in 2016. Rand Paul is almost certainly running for president. He's already building a campaign team. He's gone to some early states and made pitches to voters, Republican voters there. And on Capitol Hill, he's taken stands, like on the filibuster on the Senate floor over the president's drone policy, which have raised his national profile.
Only in Alice's Wonderland would you sentence someone before you try them?
These are all consistent with Rand Paul's effort to broaden his appeal beyond just his libertarian base and eventually win support from mainstream establishment conservatives and Republicans, something that his father was unable to do. Marco Rubio, cut a major bipartisan immigration bill.
The vast majority of Americans believe that we need to have a legal immigration system that works.
Sort of dimmed his star in the eyes of many conservatives who saw him as sort of a purist conservative. But now Rubio is certainly trying to get those Republicans back on his side. He's taking a very hard line on Obamacare. He's pushing a very restrictive anti-abortion measure as well. He's being very deliberate in his planning. And I think you'll see that kind of stepped up next year. A lot of people may bet that Paul Ryan could be eyeing a job as a future House Speaker instead of running for president. He's certainly keeping the option of running for president open. But right now, a lot of folks see him sort of digging in to his budget and even immigration work in the House, and maybe keeping the presidential talk a little bit off the radar for now. Ted Cruz certainly is considering a run for president. He is beloved by conservatives for his very hardline stances that he's taken, whether it's been on Chuck Hagel, fighting the Chuck Hagel nomination.
You explicitly agreed with the characterization of the United States as the world's bully.
Whether it's been preventing Republicans in the House or the House and the Senate from going to a conference over the budget resolution. He's been taking some very hardline stance, which people view as an effort to keep the right on his side, and which he's been able to do. Elizabeth Warren has staked out a very firm ground on the left.
Can you identify when you last took the Wall Street banks to trial?
Since coming into the Senate, whether it's been on entitlement programs to protect entitlement programs like Medicare and Social Security, or it's been on student loans on the recent debate in the Senate, she took a very firm line on that issue, even as folks were trying to cut a bipartisan compromise. These efforts have helped her build that national profile and that national following among liberals and liberal activists. And so if she were to run, she'd be able to run presumably front to Hillary's left. But at this point, it's not clear that's exactly what she wants to do. She's not signaling that that's where she's headed.